Hey everyone, welcome to our 25th wedding anniversary celebration. Unfortunately, we can't have a big party. My wife is actually fitting very beautifully, I might add, in her wedding dress. This is her original wedding dress, so we're going to just do a quick renewal of vows, and this is for family, and we wanted you all to be a part of that on our 25th wedding anniversary. So, son, take it away.
All right, I'm going to read from Mark 10:6-9. But at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. And this is my parents' marriage of 25 years is just an example of how God has blessed their marriage and our family. And that's the most important part of marriage. It wouldn't have lasted this long if it weren't for God blessing that, God joining them together, because if it weren't, that weren't the case, it would just be two corruptible people joining together and making a promise. And
corruptible people.
That doesn't ever work out.
Exactly.
So, yeah, I just want to say that I am really blessed to have you guys as my parents, and whenever I get married, if that ever happens, that I'd want you guys to be that example to me of a marriage that'll last long and that is blessed by God.
Well, thank you, son. Kazai, you want to share a verse?
In Exodus 20, it says, "Honor your father and your mother so that you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you." And I thank the Lord every day for the family that He's given me. And you guys have been such a good example for me, especially when I get married. Again, if I get married.
You'll get married.
And I just am blessed to have you guys, my parents.
Thank you. I've got a verse for Karen. Before I renew my vows to her, I want to share a quick verse, if I can find it here. Proverbs 31. Solomon shares about the ideal wife. Of course, this is a perfect woman. I don't know that any woman could ever add up 100% to this or fit every bit of this category, but this definitely describes my wife. So, dear, I want to give you this verse here. In Proverbs 31, verse 10, and we're going to go through verse 12, I believe it is. A wife of noble character, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Her husband has full confidence in her and lacks nothing of value. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. And dear, that describes you, most definitely. You have been my greatest help and support throughout all of our 25 years of marriage, and I can't wait for the next 25 years. You get more beautiful with age. It's amazing how when you're younger, you don't think about, when you're young, you always think about youthful beauty, but I tell you all the time that you get better with age and that we're going to grow old together, and I really mean that because you do get better with age, and it's just a joy being your husband and having you as my wife. So I'm promising you 25 more years plus whatever else God gives us beyond that. So that's my promise to you.
Thank you. I'm going to use a verse that many times it's out of context, just because the sinful nature of people. But I think feel like it's very appropriate for marriage and what a wife and a husband should be. And it's in Ephesians 5, 22. Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, which he is the Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever has hated his own body, but he feeds and cares for it, just as Christ does the church. It's hard for me to read now because I'm older and I can't see. but
she's have her glasses on.
I look at this, and I know people fight about submitting to their husbands, but I can say that for you, being married to you 25 years, it has been easy for me to submit to you because you have loved me as Christ loved the church. And I don't want to cry, but you have been a good example of what a husband should be. And when a husband is that right example, it's not a burden to bear to praise submit the Lord. To the husband. And thank praise you.
Lord. I love you, dear. So that's the 25th. Glad you guys could at least share it on video. But we're praying the Lord gives us 25 plus more years, and we will serve the Lord every single day of it, no doubt about it. And we thank you that God has blessed us with some wonderful kids, Joshua and Kaziah. And thank you guys for being a part of this. Bye-bye.